The Essential phone is the new kid on the block, and while I'm normally all for being nice to the new kid, the Essential $700 price point means it wants to compete with the big boys, and it would be demential to expect preferential treatment for such a quintessentially priced device. Let's get started. Inside the box, we get a rather nice braided cable, along with the USB-C dongled headphone jack, which already spells bad news for the versatility of this device. And of course, the wall plug. Here's the phone itself. Supposedly, this device is Android, boiled down to the bare essentials, also while calling it future-proof. Personally, I always thought devices from the future would have more features instead of less, but that might just be me. Let's start with the scratch test. Remember, the Mohs scale of hardness is exponential, curving significantly upward as the numbers increase. Build quality is one of Essential's big selling points, using some of the most premium materials available in the cell phone world. The Gorilla Glass 5 on the screen is a good start, scratching at level 6, with a deeper groove at a level 7. The Essential phone has the exact same scratch tolerance as the Galaxy S8 and the iPhone 7. Up here at the Cyclops-looking 8-megapixel front camera, it's under the same glass as the screen, so it's protected as well. You might be wondering to yourself at this point, where is the earpiece on this phone? Is it a piezoelectric vibrator like we saw inside the Mi Mix? And no, it's not. It's just a super thin little line up here at the top, covered in some kind of fabric. It'll be interesting to see the shape of the speaker and the audio channel configuration during the teardown, because that slot is tiny. Down at the bottom of the phone, all the buttons are still underneath the glass, so there's nothing new to check down here. The back of the phone, though, is brilliant. I do like glass phones, and the ceramic of the Essential phone takes design to the next level. Not only is the ceramic super reflective, but it's also super, super hard. We'll have to test and see if Essential's using real ceramic in a second, but since my razor blade is leaving no marks on the material, things are looking good. There are two circular holes in the top back panel. I thought the modular accessory mount would be more flush, like they are on Motorola's phones, but these are literal holes in the phone with super strong magnets inside. Kind of interesting. The two circles on the opposite side of the phone are from the dual 13-megapixel cameras. This part, I'm not a fan of. Don't get me wrong, I love dual camera setups. The zoom lens of the iPhone 7 Plus or the wide-angle lens of the LG V30 are both amazing, but I have yet to see a monochrome picture that I just needed to have in my life. The camera lens is glass, so at least that's a positive. Being so extremely flush with the back panel, though, is great aesthetically, but not when you're trying to keep scratches and damage to a minimum. We'll try to solve that in a second. But first, let's see if Essential really used a ceramic panel. Ceramic normally starts scratching at level 8, as we learned from the Ceramic Mi Mix phone last year, and it looks like that same level of hardness is achieved on this Essential phone. No marks were left by my Mohs picks until level 8. The back panel is essentially impervious to scratches. Along with the fingerprint scanner, zero damage means the hardware will continue to function long into the future. The sides of this phone are made from titanium, which is a level 6 on Mohs scale. This is not to be confused with titanium carbide, which is a level 9. These are two very different substances. Stainless steel, like my razor blade, is also around a level 6, and you can see the damage being done to the surface of the phone. Both titanium and stainless steel beat out aluminum, though, which usually sits around a level 3 or 4 depending on the alloy. And if all of that made sense, you're probably watching too many of my videos. It's not pure titanium, though, around the edge. There's a pretty sweet little plastic rim. Plastic is much more forgiving than metal, so even this minor ring pressed up against the glass will help keep pressure off the glass during a drop. If this phone survives the rest of my tests, and enough people request it, I'd be willing to drop this phone a few times before I take it apart. Let me know if you want to see a drop test down in the comments. Down here at the bottom of the phone, we find the lack of headphone jack. This phone really is just the bare essentials, which means it's barely useful if you forget to bring or charge your headphones. Personally, I own a ton of different wireless headphones. I enjoy them, but I still appreciate the convenience of my headphone jack on a regular basis. The biggest downside to the glossy ceramic back is the fingerprints, and, like I said earlier, how the camera sits flush with the back surface. One option that potentially solves both problems is a skin. This matte black skin helps keep things sleek and minimal. Or if you want more of a Khaleesi vibe, the dragon skin also looks pretty sweet. A skin raises the camera glass just enough so it's not rubbing on whatever surface you set your phone on. I'll include a link to these skins down in the video description. And big thanks to Dbrand for supporting my channel and helping make this video possible. Speaking of Dragonfire, this 5.7-inch Quad HD IPS display lasted about 9 seconds under the heat from my flame. Not invincible, but still impressive. The pixels went black and turned off, but after the heat was removed, they came back to life, which seems to happen quite a bit north of the wall. The ultimate test of build quality is the bin test. The construction of the phone says a lot about how long it will last in everyday life, and this phone does feel extremely solid and heavy, and that carries over into the bin test. It is impressively rigid and sturdy, even when flexed from both directions. Physically, this phone passes my durability test, I'm definitely impressed with the materials. Ceramic is one of my favorites, but the second monochrome camera is unappealing to me. That, combined with a lack of headphone jack, no water resistance, no SD card, and no standardized wireless charging, brings the usefulness level of this phone to a low that I'm not willing to accept. I don't need the bare essentials, I need all of the essentials. Let me know if you want to see a drop test. I think I'd rather enjoy dropping this phone onto concrete somewhere. Come hang out with me on Instagram and Twitter if you want to see a little preview. Thanks a ton for watching. I'll see you around.